Mirror's Edge Catalyst, the game the critics are raving. There's no way that this is right, Ryan. Like, no. No, I refuse to believe that this is right. There's no way that IGN actually gave this game a 6.8 out of 10 it's okay rating. How is that even possible? Did EA's check bounce or something? Did someone forget a wire transfer? I feel like calling this Ryan McNuggets guy and asking him to verify this number. Like, come on, 6.8 out of 10?
Are you sure about that?
Just to be perfectly honest, when I play Mirror's Edge games, I actually blast the trashiest Eurobeat that I can find in order to enhance the experience. Because at this point, why would I care about the plot? Like, the sexual tension isn't gonna lead anywhere if this game is rated T for teen, so even though the game can drop hints...
To think you should humble me with a visit.
I'm sorry, I should've come sooner.
Far be it from me to judge. It's not like you owe me anything.
I know there's never gonna be an end result. I mean, Faith won't even dignify one of the other characters with a fist bump.
Defeated. Don't let this happen again.
Okay, I'm kind of getting ahead of myself, so here's some background that you should know. The main character, Faith, is what's referred to as a runner, which means that she's not only an extremely fast parkour expert, but she's also massively unemployed, a juvenile delinquent, and lacking health insurance that nobody bothers to judge because her parents were murdered as a part of an 11 kill streak on High Rise by a corporate executive named Gabriel Kruger.
Let us go, Kruger.
The enemy dropped our flag!
A friendly predator missile inbound.
Bomb drop! They got their flag back!
Puppet smoke!
Enemy UAV spotted!
Our AC-130 is in the air.
Enemy SV! Enemy flag drop!
Airdrop on the way.
Mission accomplished. Well done.
Whoa, that's like... fucking mean.
Now, the whole point of the game is Faith making it her sole mission in life to metaphorically crush Gabriel Kruger and essentially any corporation that offers a product or service, which the last time that I checked was, all of them. So it's safe to say that she's not a huge fan of white males. Or capitalism.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Fuck you, McDonald's.
There are a few other people you should know about, like Birdman.
Birdman!
Yeah, I mean this Birdman, not... that Birdman. Dogen is pretty important because he's basically the Mirror's Edge equivalent of Tom Nook from Animal Crossing in that he would sell his entire family up the river if it meant another dime in his pocket.
Money, 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 motherfucker. Money on my motherfucking mind. Cut 5 haircuts at the same time. White gold pants, jet ski, made of wine.
And my personal favorite, Isabel Kruger. Oh my god, QT3.14. Not only is she the daughter of Gabriel Kruger, but she's also downright heartless when it comes to interacting with the lower class. Like, not even joking, she literally starts to die when she's forced to breathe poor people air. Like, Faith's crew kidnaps her and brings her down underground, and she says she has a hard time breathing?
All I know is that the air down here is already killing me. So you might as well get it over with.
Then later, you find out her lungs actually don't function correctly with the poor people air down in the sewers. Is that not just hysterical?
Can't breathe down here. There's something messed up with her lungs.
Now naturally, the game is all about movement and free running, but things have changed since the original, so here's what you should know. First thing, Faith has gotten significantly slower. Or at least it feels like it. Maybe my FOV is too low, but I feel so average in terms of speed, it's like any jogger on the street could keep up with me. One thing that is faster is the side strafe slash dash feature that they've added that can somehow make you violently flail your body in a particular direction at lightning speed. It basically makes combat a breeze because you can just run circles around enemies, so it's pretty damn unfair. And if that wasn't enough, they also give you a grappling hook because, you know, why not make Faith into f***ing Spider-Man? So, you have a grappling hook on your wrist, you can stun enemies with your wrist, you can stop mechanical objects with your wrist.
And it's not okay!
Another thing I found a little confusing were the haircuts. Like, everyone in the city, which happens to be called Glass, by the way, as if the citizens weren't edgy enough, has these insufferably trendy haircuts. Like, the entire society is run by stylists that are forcing people into haircuts uncomfortably often.
You need to cut it!
At least the combat's extremely fun, or should I say Mortal Kombat.
Fight.
Not to mention the enemies that are so eager to die that they basically throw themselves off ledges.
Get the fuck out of my way, bitch.
The name of the game when it comes to combat is learning how to alternate your dodging directions and knowing the difference between a light attack and a heavy attack. I don't even feel the need to teach you this because after 15 seconds of button mashing, you'll figure it out anyways. The only two types of guys you have to worry about are the ones with glitter guns attached to their forearms. And the dude's wearing black.
Let the cleanup crew dig up the body. I got better things to do.
If you really want to cheese any character, just strafe dodge them into a corner and violently kick them in the spine until they collapse like an abandoned schoolhouse in Detroit. Just so you know, you better bring your A game later on when you fight those two black sentinels because they've got the reflexes of a mongoose and the finesse of black dynamite. Quick side note, I have no idea why Faith insists on punching people in the face when they're wearing helmets. Not only is it inconsiderate, but it's also a great way to shatter your knuckles.
Orders would have captured them, but they resisted.
That shit is fucking trash, dog. Get the fuck.
The game tries to force you into synergizing your rapid movement with your combat skills to slay enemies on the move, but those moments don't come up that often. And I think you guys have noticed by now that things look different visually, but that's because the game is supposed to be quote-unquote open world. You see, the first Mirror's Edge kept you on a linear path throughout the entire story, so because you're restricted in some way, the graphics can be beefed up as a result, but because Mirror's Edge Catalyst is open world and able to be explored freely, they had to dumb things down a little, or as IGN put it, muddy graphics.
Hey, I know that's not racist. But that secretly sounds a little racist.
So yes, things look nice, but some of you that don't have monster PCs may not be blown away. And I'm not gonna spoil anything, but the last segment of the game is especially fun and beautiful. Like, the last 45 minutes is probably the most fun that I've had in a video game in the past 3 months. And that's about it. That's all that I have to say about this free-running adventure in unemployment. It's not necessarily the perfect game, but I found it to be pretty damn neato. And also, Isabel Kruger. Just, oh my god. Oh my god, he's just like, hey yo girl. I really want in on your 401k and health insurance plan.